Hi, and welcome to this video about the Debt Tracker. You can purchase this spreadsheet on my shop product page, which I'll link to below, but you can also just watch this video to get inspired to pay down your debts. This video goes over the Debt Tracker in Excel, but there's also a Google Sheets version. There are also variations for this tracker for up to 20 debts, as well as up to 30 debts. This one, as you can see, is up to 10 debts. I'll include all the links to the products below. Before I go through how to use the spreadsheet, I thought I'd point out two important notes about editing cells. Some of the cells are locked to prevent accidental changes to formulas and charts. If you want to make the cells editable, you can go to the Review tab and then click on Unprotect Sheet and then make the changes you'd like to make and then go back to the Review tab and go back to Protect Sheet. Click OK, leaving the password field blank if you'd like to preserve the formulas and the charts that are in place. The second note is about frozen panes. And so you'll see here that some of the panes are frozen, as in this heading dashboard chart summary area at the top is frozen so that you can see transactions that are far below. In the Excel version, you can always unfreeze the panes by going to the View section and then going to Freeze Panes and unfreeze the panes. Also, if you do find it at all difficult in terms of your viewing, you can go to View, Zoom, and then change the magnification here. For Google Sheets, it looks somewhat similar. You'll see that if you make any changes to the charts that are not meant to be edited, or areas that are not meant to be edited, you'll see that a warning message will come up. So you can always override it by pressing OK, but otherwise you can just press cancel. In terms of frozen panes, you'll see that the Google Sheets version, none of it's frozen just because the charts don't allow for frozen panes in that summary section. And in terms of viewing, you can change the magnification or zooming in area here. I generally recommend 75%. So back to the Excel spreadsheet. Now that you know some of those important features, how do you use the spreadsheet? The first thing you do is you go to the starting month year section and then you enter in the month and the year. So for example, and I would recommend just entering it as the month slash year in this way. You'll notice that it defaults automatically to the first, you'll see, of that month, which is fine, just because it's really meant to track on a monthly basis. Then I would go down to the current month year. So the current date, in terms of like where you're starting to enter payments. So say you started the debt tracker in January of 2022 and say today's date is March 2022, then you'll see that everything will auto update below here. And then you would also enter in the amount available. So the amount available is the amount of money you have available to dedicate to paying down your debt for that month. So say you have $1,000, you would enter that there. Then scroll down and start entering in your debt names. So you can change all these fields to like RBC credit card, if that's one of your credit card names and so forth. And then enter in the starting balance for that credit card, the amount that's owing, as well as the minimum payment, which is the minimum you have to pay in order to not get additional fees on top of the interest and get reported to the credit bureau. Then enter in the interest rate and do that for every single debt that you have outstanding. After that, scroll down and start entering your payments. So if you paid off $200 in January, you'll see that the balance will reflect your payment, or it will reflect the starting balance minus your payment plus the interest that is continuously accumulating. And it's only until you pay off that balance that it'll zero out. I highly recommend entering in a general payment plan. So for example, even if it is March for this month, I would recommend just kind of having like a projected payment plan so you can see just how you anticipate paying everything off. In terms of like changing your progress, you can always change it up here, because this is the date that you can, if it's actually February, you'll see that the progress will change. All of this information will change as well to reflect your current situation. But it's always good to just kind of plan everything out. In terms of how to plan things out, I recommend starting with the minimum payment that is recommended for each credit card or other type of debt. And then after you've entered in all of the minimum payments, then go back to the debts and start adding in additional payments depending on what overall amount you have available. So for example, you'll see here that your minimum payments are $300 in total. So you would enter in like 50, 100, 150, if this is the month of January, that is, that you're deciding on how to pay down your debt for this month. You'll see here that you'll have $700. Your minimum is 300. Your extra payment is 700. So you can then kind of start to add money to each debt to use up that 700 towards paying down your debt. Just a quick reminder that as you start to enter in information in your tracker and then come back to it, you'll always have to enter in this current month year tab to whichever current month it might be. And that will enable everything to auto update from the charts to the summaries. After you enter in your plan, you can always go back and modify things so it reflects the actual situation and the actual payments that are made. If you buy the product, there are more extensive PDF instructions with screenshots that I encourage you to read through, as there's more information about the details, best practices, and frequently asked questions. Thanks for watching this video.